What's up guys, this is the Archicad. In today's video, we are going to make some different wall sidings for different building facades. For example, this has got classical wall siding type, and here we can see 50 centimeters between these sidings part, and this is a wider from the bottom part, and decorated some the classical movements with that. And also here we have a different siding type, and it's a bit more different, and as you can see here, it's a zigzag. And if we compare this one, we don't have any space between, blank space or hollow between these lines, and there are bulges here as you can see. And also we have different siding type from here, and this profile here we have a bulge type, and a big bulge comes from here, and it's completes the shapes and covers all the facades of the building. Moving on, and this is the same as the with the first one I have shown you. This is the basic one, and the simplest. And here we have different type of facade. This time we can see our sidings not horizontally, it's vertically from this position, and it's like as some stick on this wall and pasted there. And actually this type of facades made with metal, not a wood. And here this type of facade, we can see here stones, woods and metal. We have three type of building elements, which is very nice. This is the building. Maybe you can remember this one from my gutter tutorial. As you can see here, we have placed some gutters. Anyway, for this building, I want to make this wall facade, wall surface clear, because I want to see our sidings precisely. So I want to activate the 3D visualization. And here we have surface settings. And I alt click this one. After that I click this surface, and as you can see, it was opened up in the beginning of the screen. And then I'm going to remove texture and click OK. There we go. We are going to making this type of siding. This is the simplest one. I want to show you how to make it. First we click the wall, hit Ctrl plus T, and here we have lock details. Click this one and open up this use lock wall, and we have four different types of this, and this type is the first one, and other one is something like wooden material. I want to show you. Okay, click OK. And actually we need some shadow for this. We cannot see the detail, or maybe we can right click from here, 3D styles, there we go, and detailed shading. Okay, this is better. We can see the details, but for that type, this is not the true one. Let's change something else. From this one, click OK. Yeah, this is the true one. And for the width of the space, space distance, let's go to options again. And for example, we can input here 1 meter, and we just leave as is. And there we go, this is 1 meter. And if you want to make this start with half lock, and we have to click this one. This is our first one. So if we just look from inside, as you can see here, there are locks in the inside of the building, which is we don't want that inside our building. So I don't want to suggest these settings. Okay, let's get rid of this and go to our second type. And for this type, we are going to make something different. Let's go to profile tool from options menu, complex profiles, and profile manager. We are going to click new one and let's call this siding. Click OK. Here we are in the profile manager window and we are going to sketch it first with some lines and some fills. Let's click the line tool and for the height, first we are going to make the height of the building, so it was 300 centimeters. It comes to here. After that, I want to make as 20 centimeters for the siding part. And here we have 2 centimeter main thickness. And from here, it's going to move down to the bottom part. And connect with these lines. And we can delete the inner. And click them all. Ctrl plus U. We are going to click drag and increment and speed for multiply. Click the bottom part to the top of the this part. And actually, I want to fill this inside. So by doing that, we don't have to make it again. Maybe we can use this insulation fiber hard. Hit the space bar, click the inside. There we go. And after that, again, Ctrl plus U. Click here. And to the here. And also I want to make this, use this with walls. And maybe, I don't know, maybe we can use in the BIM tool. And for the surface, actually this is going to be finished material. Override surfaces. To override surfaces, let's all click this fill type. Hit Ctrl plus A and click override surfaces. And here we go, some elements. For example, maybe we can go with paint 12 and hit the save. Here we are going to apply the siding onto this wall. So in order to do that, we are going to use another wall tool and we are going to make a new layer from Ctrl plus L for this layer menu, or you can just go to documents, click layers and click this layer, click the new and let's call this siding. And here this part is important. We are going to make this 1, 2, 2 and click update. It was selected also. We are going to use drafting. Click OK. And here before applying our wall again, siding wall, we are going to select from here, siding there. And we are going to click this structure, go to profile, open this up and click siding. Here we can start from this corner and as you can see here, it's turning to left, but I want to make this to turn right. So here we have reference line location, flip, click this one. Here we go. And start from here to here. And go to 3D. As you can see here, we have applied all siding onto the wall. I can hear you that you are asking me to openings for the windows. Let's do that first. From the new opening tool, from the left, which was it? Here we go. Opening and click the wall. That's all it, and click the edge of the opening and enlarge something like this. Actually, where was it? Here we go. And connect the edges to the window. After that, you can directly copy of your opening and apply to your windows, like so. Moving on to the other types, and this is the same. We are just going to change the shape. Click the siding and click edit. Actually, we can duplicate this one, and let's call this siding 2. And I want to make here a line to determine the height of the wall, and just delete. Okay, we have already as 300 centimeters wall height, and for the profile type is something like the same, but here we have a corner from here, and I'm gonna split this line from here. After that, click this edge and make a bulb like so, and maybe we can make a deeper corner for this. There we go. And after that, let's click the fill. Maybe move to here, all click the fill, hit space and click inside. There we go. Select all of them, hit Ctrl plus U, click OK. Align bot and top and complete the shape. Click the save. There we go. We have our siding too. Let's go to floor plan. From the floor plan, we can directly copy this one and rotate. And we can just close this trace. It's getting the computer slow. Let's reduce this length to here. And since it was selected, we just go to the structure siding and click siding 2, and after that we can click directly from the floor plan our opening and apply our siding. Let's go to 3D, and here we go. We have our siding 2. Moving on, last type of siding. Here we have our vertical siding type. In order to do this, we can directly use objects to our facade. Maybe columns or morph tool. Let's just go with morph tool. Click the morph and click the rectangle. I'm gonna click from here and maybe to the here. There we go. After that, we are going to click the face and make extrude is 1 centimeter, and for the material, this was brick material. Let's make the same brick. Wait, I think it was it. Okay, here we go. And again, Ctrl plus U, click the corner and just array like so. And after that, we can just click our morphs from here. And here we have this split, which I have Shift plus S for the shortcut. Click that one and click this bottom face of the window and click somewhere here and make the same to this face, and this time click upside and delete. This is the face display, but this is not parametric. For example, if I say you please change this space between these sticks, you have to go to beginning and repeat the same settings and same steps from the start over. This is not convenient way of doing this. Here is my other solution using railing tool, and click the railing tool, go to settings, click segments, and let's just get rid of this unnecessary railing parts, and maybe we can get rid of this one. And here we have only inner post, and for the heights or segment top, let's make this 0. Let's go to segment top, and for the height, we're gonna make this 300 centimeters. And for the space between the inner post, this is the parametric part of this railing. So we can input any distance we want. Maybe 25 centimeters. If you are not happy with these settings, you can always go back to here and change the settings. Click OK. And from here to here. And after that, change the direction from here. And let's make this offset 0. And for the post type, from the railing post, inner post component settings, let's click this rectangular. For the depth, let's input this one. For the thickness, let's input here 2. And as for the color, we are going to go to this 3D presentation, and here we have override post surfaces. Open that up and click that surface and go to brick red brown and click OK. And we can always go to back to here and change our space from here. And to make opening for our windows, we can use morph tool for that. Maybe we can apply this for this window, but before that I want to explain you is we are going to make this morph to here, and we are going to change layer settings and make it hidden. And before hidden, we are going to apply Boolean operation. Let's just extrude maybe like so, and some push ring inside, and right click this one, connect, and solid element operation. As you are in the operation menu, we are going to make this operator and make this target. Let's click this subtraction and execute. And after that, we are going to make this layer hidden. There we go. This is our third type and fully parametric. Let's change this to 30 centimeter, and for the thickness, let's make this maybe 2.5 and click OK. And also I want to make this open up the hidden, and I'm gonna duplicate from here to here, hit the shift from the keyboard to lock into the place, lock into the line, and click the corner, click this get operator, click this siding get target element, hit execute, click the morph. Actually it's already hidden, and so here it is turned to custom. Open up this custom, and we are going to click this zero to drafting again, and there we go. So this pretty much it covers this tutorial, uncovers some of the secret tools and tips and tricks on how can you make sidings on different types, on different facade types in Archicad. Alright, if this was interesting, please subscribe and like and share this video. And also if you want some of my advanced SP Archicad courses, check out my Patreon, the first link in the description. Also, if you are interested in this project files, all of my project files can be found there as well. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.